So the Fibonacci sequence is a sequence of numbers where the first two numbers are equal to 1, as you can see, and the numbers after that, each one is equal to the sum of the two previous numbers before it. So for example, this number over here is equal to 1 plus 1. This one is equal to 1 plus 2. And this one is equal to 2 plus 3. And this goes on. So now we want to write a program where the user gives us a number n. And we want to give him the nth Fibonacci number. For example, if the user enters 1, we give him 1 because the first Fibonacci number is equal to 1. If the user enters 3, we give him 2. If the user enters 5, we give him 5. If the user enters 100, then we have to calculate the 100th Fibonacci number and give it to him. Okay? So let's do this. First of all, I'm taking n from the user, as you can see. So if the user wants the first or the second Fibonacci numbers, they are equal to 1. So if n is equal to 1 or n is equal to 2, then let's printf the Fibonacci number is 1. Okay, and let's end the program over here. So we don't want to execute the rest of the code. Now, if the user wants something different than the first or the second Fibonacci number, then we want to calculate this number and give it to him. So let's make a variable and let's call it Fibonacci number and let's initialize it to 0. In this variable, we will store the Fibonacci number that the user wants. Now, let's imagine that we want the third Fibonacci number, so n is equal to 3. Then we have to add this and this, and we got 2, which is the third Fibonacci number. So we made the addition one time. Now, if n is equal to 4, then we have to add these two numbers, and then we have to add these two, and we get our Fibonacci number. So we made the addition twice. If we want the fifth Fibonacci number, we have to add these two, and then add these two, and then add these two over here in order to get our Fibonacci number. So with n equal 5, we have to do the addition 3 times. As you can see, we have a pattern. So if I want the nth Fibonacci number, I have to do the addition n minus 2 times, right? So we want to do some code over here, n minus 2 times. So let's use a for loop, int I equal 1, I is less than or equal to n minus 2 and I plus plus. So this will repeat my code n minus 2 times. Now in here, we have to figure out how are we going to calculate this Fibonacci number. Let's start with some examples. Let's suppose n is equal to 3. So if n is equal to 3, my Fibonacci number is going to be equal to 1 plus 1, right? The 1 plus 1 is the first two numbers of the Fibonacci sequence. So let's define these numbers over here. Int i1 is equal to 1 and i2 is also equal to 1. So these are my first two numbers of the sequence. So my Fibonacci number is going to be equal to i1 plus i2. So if I want the third Fibonacci number, I is equal to 1, I will be less than or equal to 3 minus 2, which is 1. So the condition is true. So Fibonacci number will be equal to 1 plus 1, which is 2. And then we will increment I. Now I is equal to 2. And 2 is not less than or equal to 1. So we will get out of the loop. And we have our Fibonacci number, which is equal to 2. Perfect. Now let's suppose n is equal to 4. So I want you to imagine this. I1 is over here and I2 is over here. And the Fibonacci number variable is now over here. Now, if I want to sum these two numbers, as you can see, we are adding up I1 and I2. So let's move I1 and I2 over to these numbers, okay? So I1 was here and I2 was here. Now, to move I1 over here, all we have to say I1 equals I2. So let's do this. So I1 is equal to I2. Now you can imagine that I1 is over here. Now we need to move I2 over here. Right? So I2 will be equal to our Fibonacci number because our Fibonacci number is over here. Perfect. Now over here we are adding these two numbers and the result will be stored inside Fibonacci number. So 1 plus 2 will give me 3. As you can see, we got our Fibonacci number. If we continue, I1 will be here and I2 will be here, and if we sum these two, we get this number. Perfect. So we are adding the numbers properly and we are getting the number that we want. And this condition over here controls whenever we get out of the loop. So let's try for n equal 5, for example. So first we added these two, I1 and I2, and we stored them inside Fibonacci number. So Fibonacci number is equal to 2. Now I1 is equal to 1 and I2 is equal to 2. So Fibonacci number will be equal to 1 plus 2, which is equal to 3. Now I1 is equal to 2 and I2 is equal to 3. So Fibonacci number over here is equal to 2 plus 3, which is equal to 5. As you can see, we made 3 iterations, and after we execute this code, I will be incremented, so I will be equal to 4. So 4 is not less than or equal to 3. So we will get out of the loop and we have our Fibonacci number, which is equal to 5. So all we have to do is to printf the Fibonacci number is, it's an integer, and it is our variable Fibonacci number. Perfect. So let's build and run this program. So enter n. Let's say I want the first Fibonacci number. We get 1, and this is the code over here. Another example, the second one, we also get 1, also the code over here. Now let's try the third Fibonacci number, and we get 2, and this is correct. Another example, let's try the fifth Fibonacci number, and we have 5. Perfect. Let's try for n equal 7. Now we have the Fibonacci number is 13, and this is correct. It is the number over here. Now if n equal 100, and as you can see, we get a negative number. This is because the 100th Fibonacci number is very big and we cannot store it inside an integer. But this is not our topic in this case. If you are interested, I will put a link in the resources regarding this matter. But regarding our program, the question is solved. Now let's turn this question into a function. So let's suppose that the user gives us an integer n, and we want to use this function to get the Fibonacci number. So the Fibonacci number is %d fib of n, just like this. So this function takes an integer and returns the nth Fibonacci number. The implementation would be something like this. If n is equal to 1 or n is equal to 2, return 1. And again, because we have a return statement over here, the rest of the code will not be executed. We exit the function. Okay. And if n is different than 1 and n is different than 2, we will have to calculate the Fibonacci number. So just like before, these are the first two numbers. This is our variable. We are calculating the Fibonacci number and we are returning it. So let's try this function. Let's build and run the program. Let's enter 7, for example, and we have 13. So this is working properly. So this is it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.